All right. So, why do you make music? What is your relationship with music like?
I shouldn't ask that if I didn't think it was gonna be edited.
Oh, I fucking love it. It's been my dad was a band teacher, so it's been a part of my life since I was basically born.
Like at first, it was just a way to kind of express myself, I guess. As a kid, you don't really think of it any way other than that. At least I didn't. I just thought of it as like this really cool way to express yourself. I heard, you know, I heard a certain artist and music that I liked at a very, very young age, and I noticed connection with it just at an extremely young age, like and then it bordered on obsession right around like 8 years old. Like I just couldn't get songs out of my head, or like I just wanted to, like, I don't, you know, I didn't know how to play guitar or sing or put notes together or anything. I just knew that I really liked the way certain songs made me feel. So I, you know, that was like the initial inspiration. And at this point, it's literally just a, it's like another language to me, you know. It's just, I make music now because I feel like I have to. Like, not an obligation, but I feel like it's just this thing that I have to do. Like, it's, my whole life feels like a song that I've just been writing for, you know, 35 years.
Right.
I think it sort of like saved my life in many ways. Like, I didn't know what I wanted to do when I was younger, and I saw my older brother in music, and then I saw the rest of my family in music, my friends, all the things. And then, you know, I was kind of confused, I was a little bit discouraged. I was like, oh, I don't want to be like my brother, I don't want to do this, but like, yeah, no, it definitely led me in the right direction for many reasons. So it helps me, and it helps me help other people. That's what I
mean. I would just say with, it sounds kind of spooky, but almost with the universe, where it's like, everything is connected, and everything has a certain tone to it. It doesn't matter what it is, black, white, everything's created and has been created, and nothing can really change. But you can morph it. You can make it into different ideas, and that's my relationship with music. I'm creating something from sometimes nowhere, but a lot of times I'm just creating something from something else. Like, I see a piano, I'm like, okay, what's a song that would describe a piano? And like, you can play around with it, you can do anything you really want with it, but the core idea is just that, like, I cannot. Let me do another take. That was terrible. I should have said these questions before. I could have thought about this.
It's cooler to be on the spot.
Huh?
I think it's more real to be on the spot with it.
Yeah, but it's hard to describe, you know? Because, like, I don't really think about this shit. Like, it's more just like, I don't even, like, when I write music or make music or anything, I don't feel like it's me doing it. Like, I sort of feel like it's something just coming through me.
Are we taking over?
Yeah, I'm not even taking over. Like, I'm still doing it. Like, you know what I mean? I'm still aware that I'm doing it. But it's like, where the ideas come from, where that lick came from, where the timing comes from. It's just like, it's all unconscious.
I've genuinely always loved it. I treat it as if it's my first love. Gets annoying sometimes in the practice room. Better on good days than not, I mean, as anything is. But I've had to make it a priority sometimes, but I've yet to regret making it a priority.
It doesn't take the joy out of it for you?
Well, I feel like music can be divided up into craft and art. Craft can be a bitch. Can I curse?
Yeah.
Craft can be a bitch. It's getting the right technique down, getting the right thing in this part of the spot, and X, Y, Z. Which is my freshman year, I had an opportunity to decide if I wanted to be a bass clarinetist, an instrumentalist, or a vocalist. And I chose singing more because it's less. Yes, it's still about the craft and about how to make your voice work and know exactly and everything like that, but it's much more playful. And you can incorporate the art into the craft, I feel like, more
with voice. I'm not to say that you can't do it with instruments, but I find it personally just easier to do so. And the art is really just where the fun comes in. The last couple weeks, the last month, sometimes leading up to a performance or getting to a certain spot in my practicing where it's just like, I just get to worry about the meaning of the text and why the composer wrote this piano instead of forte, but it's such a powerful moment or something like that. That's the fun of it. That's just the philosophy behind it, the thinking behind it, and just simply the doing behind it. Like, yeah.
Are there any artists that you take inspiration from in your music making? Why them?
Like now? Is this all present tense?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's never one specific artist. It's usually a lyric or a hook or a riff or a chord progression that I think to myself, damn, I wish I would have wrote that, or I could have wrote that, and like somebody else beat me to it.
One is Ren. He's a British angry rapper, and he talks about mental health, and what he talks about is real. He talks about taking down the patriarchy, and he's got some really sick tunes. And I like that kind of music. I'm not really a big classical person because that's what was important back then and it's still important now. But I like music that means something with what we're going on with today.
I feel like everyone and everything to an extent. Just by seeing it or hearing it or reading it or consuming it in any way automatically makes it a part of you. Whether you choose to or not, whether you open yourself up to it or not, it's still some sort of memory and it's gonna be a part of you. And I think that's just what makes your artistry is just the culmination of all of your past experiences, regardless of what they are. And you can bring stuff out more here and there and all, but specific artists, I listened to Jonas Kaufman a lot when I was younger. Really, really just a passionate verismo singer, and I'm a tenor who always wanted to be a baritone or a bass, and would love to still be a bass for a day, and he has that sound. So on the downside, it made me want to sound like him, which I just can't do, but on the plus side, the passion behind his music really gets me. And similarly, just... Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm having a struggle finding like artists, think of artists specifically rather than genres. I'm thinking more like soul music.
That's fine.
I grew up with a lot of American music in my household, kind of think American rock or Aretha Franklin or just old classic rock or old classic American stuff. Folk music too. It's very storytelling, very, very raw. A lot of it at least. Regardless of what specific genre. I'd say the more soulful, the more emotional an artist is the more I'm drawn to them.
Tyler, the Creator. Just cause he's so like fucking out there, you know? And like he doesn't care, like he does every genre. Like Igor had every fucking genre on it. And the same thing with, what's the latest album? Call Me If You Get Lost. Bro, he had a fucking like trap song next to like a 90s R&B, then he had a reggae, like, you know what I'm saying? I love the diversity, because a lot of artists are kind of stuck doing one or two things these days. Cough, cough. No, I'm joking. Let's see, who else? I mean, obviously like the GOATs. I was a classical musician, so I love Beethoven, Bach, Mozart, everyone else. And everyone else.
I also like the band Oh Wonder. They also talk about similar things, similar vibes. They're a little bit more low key, and they have a common way of talking about more emotional, inner people things, which I think music is a great way to deal with that. So.
And I'm just inspired by things that evoke like an emotion, you know, like anything that, so I don't have bias towards any artist. I'd never say like, oh, that, you know, like that singer sucks or that band sucks. Like, I always keep my mind open where if something moves me, it'll inspire me. So I'm not beholden to like one particular artist that like motivates me to keep doing something. It's just, you know, like for example, like the Red Hot Chili Peppers, like they've been dormant for several years now, like a long time, a long span has gone by, and they reunited with their old guitarist, and these guys are in like their late 50s, early 60s. They've been doing that. They're in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. They don't have to do any more heavy lifting as far as their careers are concerned. They're all set. You know, they're all millionaires and they're fine. They don't have, but they just came out with like this new album that's just, it's incredible. It's one of their best albums they've ever made. And it's like that inspires me. Like, if you want a modern, yeah, like the Red Hot Chili Peppers' new record, Unlimited Love, just really lit me on fire. Like, wow, these guys don't have to do shit. They don't have to do anything. And they just made one of the best records of their entire lives. And they're that deep into their career. That is inspiring to me.
Cool.
Mm-hmm.
Can you describe how it feels to make music? To play?
It feels like breathing. It's cheesy, but like when I'm not playing anything, when I'm not jamming out or any of that stuff, then I don't feel like I'm being as heard. But as soon as I start playing the cello or the mandolin or anything like that, then I feel like, yeah, I can actually speak now.
It feels like, I mean, it basically feels like a bodily function to me at this point. I've been doing it for so long. Like, I got into it at such a young age. Like, now it literally feels like a reflex. So, like, making music feels like a reflex to me. It feels like, you know, breathing.
Like, I just don't want to sound crazy when I give these answers, because it really is not like a personal experience for me. It's like a very out of body experience. It's like if you just feel, and it's like if you've ever like played like a sport at a very high level, like you get to a point where you're not really thinking about playing anymore. You're sort of just like thinking about what to do. You're just like, all right, we need to do that. So you're not thinking like, oh, I have to run that way. You're just like, you just do it. You know what I mean? And kind of the same thing with music, but like on a little bit of a deeper level, because like there really isn't any rules or guidelines to follow. It's sort of you just make it up. So it really feels like it comes from this place that's kind of almost beyond me. I just write something and like I like it. And like even when I'm listening to it, it's just like I'm not listening to like what I created. I'm like, I'm curious into like how it sounds. Like I'm listening to a new song. It's just like, ooh, like, wow. It's kind of bizarre, but like that's it. I tried my best.
it felt just all here, and I here, and it just, I wanted to, sorry, I think I'm realizing something right now as I'm saying this. I wanted to like come in on it and not maybe hold it in a way of cradling it where it wanted to come out. Jesus Christ, have I been performing those pieces wrong the whole time? Oh my God, I'm sorry, I think before.
I feel like subconsciously you probably knew how you really felt about it though.
Yeah.
Even if you like didn't channel all of that, you still like had that, you wouldn't be saying it otherwise.
Yeah, but yeah, sorry, no, but wanting to cradle it all, and it just, it felt all inside me, and which is how singers work, kind of thing, leaving that full space to just let everything come out, and having just a pathway, a free queer pathway for everything to just, for the sound to go through, for the music to go through, because it all starts down here, if not down here. It just certainly wasn't easy. Making the music was easy. Making the sound wasn't, but making the music was indescribable. I can feel literally exactly how it felt going through my body right now, from the belly button, the diaphragm, just all the way through, and not touching a thing in between. And I remember my face being all cramped up in certain spots just because I had to have my mouth open for a fucking C sharp. And I stopped thinking about the technique, because you never think about technique when I perform. If I do, I fucked up. And it's very noticeable, because it takes away from the character and the music entirely, in my opinion, which is why I'm very picky about the instrumentalists I listen to sometimes. I'm sorry. I remember my eyes squinting, not closing, and because just my cheeks were high and raised and everything was open, my jaw was dropped, and just...
Okay. Why do you think human beings are musical?
Oh. I feel like because we're incredibly emotional creatures, and the quickest way to get to anyone's heart is through music and through art. So I think not only is it a way of self-expression, but it's also a way of communicating. It is the one universal language that everyone can understand, even if it's just through rhythm, because that's the basic of everything. So yeah, I think it's our universal language and the only thing that really connects everybody.
Why do you think human beings are musical?
It's in nature. I think all art, especially and including music, maybe not especially, just all art in general, none of it's original, all is derived from nature, and the world, universe, or technology around us. I haven't looked much into technology yet, but sorry, I've thought about this, started thinking about this year. Why are humans innately, or is it innately musical, or?
Just why are human beings musical? Like, why are people, why do they make, listen to, like, create, digest music?
I think it's just an aspect of humanhood, a certain type of artistry. Not everyone's musical, but and maybe not everyone's an artist, but definitely everyone has some sort of, if someone has a drive of anything artistic, it's gonna come from nature. The literature describes the world around us, or our head inside of us, or our bodies inside of us. Our bodies outside of us, I don't know. And painting represents it all visually, and music can do the same orally. We hear the wind, we hear the bird songs. That's why I love spring so much. The bird songs and everything like that. I think we're musical, humans are musical because it's already around us. And we seek patterns just as a human as well. And there's so many musical patterns in music. Or so many musical patterns in nature, that's what I'm gonna say. Yeah. Yeah.
All right, this is the last question.
Okay.
Why do you think human beings are musical?
Because we're creative. We just have a natural tendency to want to document our time here on Earth, you know? And we do that in various means. Some people do it in construction, architects. Some people do it in wildlife. They're like planners and growers. But like everyone, I feel, has like a subtle urge to create. And it might come out in different ways, you know. For me, it came out in music, and for a lot of other people, it came out in music. Because, I mean, if you look into the science of it, maybe it's because, like, we were just more inclined to audio stuff, you know. But, yeah, it's just an urge to create. It's just being human.
Why do you think human beings are musical?
Oh, that's easy. They want to express something more colorfully than they could if they just said it. Like, that's why musicals are so, I used to hate musicals. Like, why are they, you know, singing it where they could just say it? And it's just more expressive. Like, music is a way to emote these thoughts and feelings that you just can't do when you write something down, just read it, or when you just say it. Like, when it's delivered, you know, musically, it's so impactful. Like, it makes you, it can make you angry, it can make you happy, it can make you sad, it can make you all these things. Like, it just opens up all these doors that just otherwise would stay closed, you know. Like, you need it. Like, there's songs that, like, you just attach to, like, a certain time in your life, or like, where there's hope, or there's, it's magical. It's a real, I don't know, it's like a life-saving skill for yourself and for others. Like, it's just, I think people need it because they just need, like, words. When words aren't enough, you know, music is like stepping up to the plate and, like, delivering, you know. It's like more, it's more detail, it's more emotion, it's more color, it's more everything.
Thank you.
Yes.
Okay.
Whenever you're ready.
She says there is joy inside me, and I just have to trust where my heart goes. She says there is light inside me, but sometimes all I see are the shadows. She says there's a star inside me, burning up my soul every day. She says there is God inside me, and God is everything, darkness and light, all the same, all the same. How I tremble when she types out my name. Oh, you fool, you fool, it's all within yourself. Oh, you fool, you fool, it's all within myself. How lucky for me, a girl across the sea who speaks to me in whispering emoji. I found her, and she found me in the lonely, ugly chaos of the internet.
That was awesome.
Waiting, watching the clock as 4 o'clock has got to stop. Hail me. Take no more. She practices her speech as he opens the door. He rolls over, pretends to sleep as he looks her over. She laughs and says she.